flashing light was seen by a young naval officer, Midshipman Stanley Veal, just after the Navy had released the Fouts from examination. He was still unaware that the war had been declared. Veal saw only the final part of the message, but understood instantly that war had begun. He promptly signaled the gunners by flag, directing that the Fouts be stopped immediately.
Flag Romeo, hoist!
Seconds after both messages from Queenscliff were received, Bombardier Perdue's gun detachment was roused to action. Just moments before, Perdue had been complaining about the icy winds that roared across Bass Strait and about last night's stew that the cook had, as usual, managed to ruin. The telephone orders from Fort Queenscliff brought an immediate response from the gunners at Fort Napier. Are you sure the Fouts is to be sunk if it does not surrender? The question was immediately referred back to the government in Melbourne, who, after some rapid discussion, confirmed the order. The Fouts was to be made to surrender and, if necessary, sunk. The order confirmed, the artillery detachment, including Bombardier Perdue, tracked the Fouts through the gun sites. A flag order was swiftly raised at Fort Nepean, directing the Fouts to heave to. But the flag order was either not seen by the Germans are ignored, and the Fouts continued with haste on its way to the Heads and freedom, which was now so very, very close. Seconds later came the terse command that Bombardier Perdue and the rest of the gun detachment had been expecting. Shot 100 years ago, ladies and gentlemen.